Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. So today's video is going to be a declutter video, but it's not going to be a traditional sort of a declutter that you see like normally on YouTube. It's going to be more of like sit down and talk through kind of declutter. So basically, in general declutter videos, what you see is people having their entire makeup collection or like whatever declutter they're doing, like maybe a blush declutter or an eyeshadow palette declutter. So they just have everything laid out, and on front of the camera itself, like while actually filming it, they decide what they want to declutter and what they want to keep. But for me, I don't have such a huge collection, and there is not a ton that I wanted to declutter. So I thought that I can just pick out the products, select what I want to give away to maybe like friends or, you know, anyone who I know who might use these products more than I do. So I just selected everything and I have them to share with you. So I have 5 products, and most of them are lipsticks. I just have 1 face makeup product, so I'll start with that first. So this is the Lakme Absolute Illuminating Shimmer Brick, and this is the pink one. And let me show you what it looks like. So I'm sure you know what a shimmer brick looks like. It basically has strips of like different products, and this one has a pink which is very pigmented, so you can't use this on its own, otherwise it will be really bright and pink. It has 1 highlight sort of shade, it has 1 brownish shade, and then 1 peachy corally shade. So you can basically just swirl your brush into it and use the entire thing, or you can use them individually. It does have a lot of different uses. So in the beginning, I did use it like all over as a blush, but I felt that I could not use it that frequently because this is very, very shimmery, and I'm more of a like satin blush or a matte blush kind of girl. I don't like super duper shimmery blushes on my cheeks. That is just personal preference. So that's the reason why I felt like I was not using this a ton as a blush. So then I started using this as an eyeshadow, like a shimmery eyeshadow. I used to use individual strips, but I found these shades to be very, very chalky, and I used to get a lot of fallout and not so much of pigment on my eyes. And then I just did not like using it anymore, and I realized that maybe I can just, you know, give this away to a friend. I actually know a friend who does not have a ton of blushes, and she would love a shimmery blush because I'm more of like a neutral makeup kind of a girl, but she likes a more glam makeup compared to me, so we kind of have different preferences, and this one would be a lot better for her. So I thought I'll just give this to her, but I still want to share like swatches of these to show you what the colors look like. So I'll just swatch them for you, and these are very I want to say like not perfect swatches, but yeah. So this is the lightest not the lightest shade, the top shade, this one, the pink, then the highlight shade. The brown looks like this, so it's like a coppery brown, and then this is the peachy shade. It's got some gold to it. So yeah, this is what this shimmer brick looks like, and like you can see, all the shades are very, very shimmery, which is why, like I mentioned, I'm not a very big fan of it. But anyways, moving on next to the lip products which I have to share. The first one that I have is the Colourpop Ultra Satin Lip, and this one is in the shade Aquarius. Now the reason why I do not like this shade a lot is because, again, I want to swatch it once and show you guys. It's a really nice nude color, but on me personally, this kind of tends to like wash me out. When I swatch it, it might not look like it will wash me out, but when I actually apply this on my lips, it does wash me out. This is the shade right here. It does not look like that. It actually looks pretty similar to what I have on my lips right now, but they're actually very, very different. This one has a lot more warmth to it, and this one is a lot more nude, so it does not really go very well with my complexion. Secondly, I'm not super duper fond of the Ultra Satin Lip formulation. It's a little bit more tacky and it does not dry down completely. I don't really prefer those sort of lipsticks. I mean, if liquid lipsticks are drying, I don't really mind that, but I want my lipsticks to really last very well on the lips. This one also fades pretty easily compared to the Ultra Matte Lip, because again, it's a more like hydrating and comfortable formulation. That's the reason why. But I'm not really fond of the formulation any which ways, and since the color washes me out, I thought I can just declutter this and give it to someone whose complexion this will still suit, someone who's like fairer than I am. So yeah, I'll be decluttering this one as well. Moving on next to the Miss Claire Soft Matte Lip Cream. Now, I know a lot of people really love the Miss Claire Soft Matte Lip Creams. And there was a time back in the day when I also loved this because, first of all, it is so affordable. Secondly, it's perfect for everyday wear. And it's also so comfortable on the lips. But what I have used, what I have noticed since I've been using this and a lot of other liquid lipsticks and like lip creams and all of that, that this one does not last as long as a lot of other lipsticks do. Like this one, after you have a meal, will kind of fade away, and it's not something that you can retouch up like on top. You'll have to completely get rid of it and then apply another layer. And if you're someone who's like on the go, you're going to college and then you hang out with friends, or even if you go to office and you have meetings to attend and you're traveling a lot, you probably will not have the time to do all that. So I personally like a lipstick which either like does not fade and it stays in place even though it is drying, or it fades really evenly and at least leaves behind a stain. Like the lipstick I have currently right now, again, does not last very well throughout the day. First of all, it's not a liquid lipstick, it's actually a lip crayon. And if you're wondering which one this is, it's Caramel Toffee from the Lakme Masaba collaboration. So this one again does not last, and it's not as pigmented like it is right now when it's like first applied. It does not stay that way throughout the day, but it does leave behind a stain and it does not fade unevenly, which I really like about it. But this one fades really unevenly, and then I don't like the way it looks at the end of the day. It looks super duper like patchy and uneven on my lips, and that's the reason why I don't really like this. So I'll probably give this to someone who does not mind that and who can do with it. And since it's a really nice nude pink color, I think it'll be great for any college going girl. And again, like I mentioned for the other shimmer brick, I do have a friend who will also love this one, and she actually wanted this shade, so I can give it to her and she can use it a lot more than I will. Moving on to the last two lip products which I have. This is the MUA or Makeup Academy lipstick, and it's in the shade Persian Rose. So I got this in one of my subscription boxes, and the thing with this one is that it's a cool toned pink, and it's like very blue toned. It's super duper blue toned, like really blue toned, and this is something that I feel will not complement Indian complexions that well. That is the first reason why I'm not super duper fond of this, because of the actual color. Secondly, I did find like a match, basically another lipstick which I can mix with this one and use, and that is the Avon Simply Pretty Color Bliss lipstick in the shade Superstar Pink. So this is I want to see, where do I swatch this? Okay, I'll swatch it here. This is like an orangey red sort of a lipstick. This is what it looks like, and I'll actually swatch this on top of the pink to show you. So when you mix these two, it becomes a nice like warm sort of a pink, and that is how I had planned I will use these two lipsticks and like just use them up. And I kind of do really like the color as well, but when I was going through my lipsticks and picking out the lipsticks that I want to declutter, I realized that both of these lipsticks, I don't have like a lot of wear time left out of these. Like the MUA lipstick, there is no expiration date on this one, but this one will expire in probably a year approximately. And since I have so many lipsticks, I don't think I'll be able to use them before they expire. And then I also have a lot of other shades as well which might probably expire in like a similar time frame, and I do want to use up lipsticks which I enjoy using. I don't want to just use them up for the sake of it. And eventually, of course, I will not be able to use up all the lipsticks that I have before they expire. So I just thought that let me not force myself to use these and just give this away to someone else who might enjoy using this more than I do, who might like a shade like this, they can either again mix it together and use it, or use either of these individually however they want to. Someone who does not have a lot of lipsticks and is just getting into makeup, I can probably give this to like one such friend and they can enjoy using this more. So that's the reason again I thought I'll declutter these. And another reason which just popped up into my mind actually is that nowadays I'm a lot more into matte lipsticks and liquid lipsticks, and these are more like satiny finish or cream finish ones. So again, not my absolute favorite, so I know I will not love these and like enjoy using them a ton, so it's better that I give it to someone else. And yes, those were all the products which I'm planning to declutter, giving it away to friends, and I hope you enjoyed watching this video. All I would like to tell you guys is that no matter how big or how small your collection is, I'm pretty sure that there might be some products which they're not your absolute favorite. And again, this is personal preference. Some people feel that, you know, if I've spent money on something, then I should use it no matter I like it or I don't like it. Some people just let it be and then the products just expire and then they throw it away. But what I personally feel is that, first of all, it's totally okay to buy something but then just give it away to someone else, because ultimately what's important is that you've spent the money and in some sort of way you should get your money's worth. If you can give it to someone else and they can use it, I feel that you still get your money's worth out of it, because the product is getting used. Once it expires, you can't use it anymore, then you just have to throw it away, and it's just a sheer waste of both money and resources which go into manufacturing that product. So I think that is very, very important, and you should keep that in mind and go through your collection regularly and see what products you have and see whether you want to keep them, whether you want to use them, what you want to do with them. But don't just forget about them completely, because you might find it after a few years or maybe after a couple of months, and you might realize that the product has expired and you can't use it anymore, and that will be really sad. Because I know it happens a ton with me, and I don't want the same thing to happen with you guys, which is why I wanted to let you know. And I know I've been like blabbering a lot, so I will end this video quickly now. And I really hope that you found this video helpful in some sort of way. If you did, then please do subscribe to my channel. It would mean the world to me. And also hit on the notification bell, which is next to the subscribe button, because that way you'll get to know when I post a new video. I will leave the names of all of the products in the description box, just in case, you know, you wanted to know if I was talking too fast and you could not like keep pace with that, then I will leave the names in the description box. You can go through them if you want to, and I will also leave my social media handles in the description box. I have an Instagram and a Snapchat, so you can follow me there as well. And yes, that is that's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. Until next time. Bye.